بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. أما بعد، أحبتي في الله، I just wanted to offer some humble advice to our brother, to those brothers and sisters who are new reverts, and especially to a particular brother. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless him with ikhlas, with thabat ala sunnat al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in that I had the honor of meeting this brother, and we spent time during the Eid, which can be a lonely time for us as reverts, that we don't have, most of us don't have Muslim families, unless we have Muslim in-law families, and Eid can be a lonely time for a lot of the reverts. So this is very important, that those are times that the brothers should strive to make some time to stick together. If there's, you know, some short period of time, if nothing else, to go eat, to go have some tea or coffee or whatever the case may be, to have a short kalima, you know, a short lecture, if you will, that reminds one another about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's religion. And so those are very important things to help strengthen us. And so I wanted to offer a few advice, pieces of advice to our beloved brother who is a new Muslim and that we had the opportunity to spend some time with, walillah alhamd. And first and foremost, I want to say is make your intention for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in everything that you do, is that you have sincerity to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and that you sincerely learn more about your faith. And that comes by seeking Islamic knowledge to the best of your ability, sitting, as you mentioned, you're going to have begin some Quran, learning how to read the Quran, and this is khair azim, this is immense good, and this is immensely beautiful for your heart and an excellent place to start, and to also read what you are going to learn by learning the Arabic language, to also read it in English to help strengthen your heart and to understand what you are learning. A second piece of advice is also reading much from the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, like Bukhari and Muslim, and not be quick to gain that knowledge and make a ruling, because this is what many of us did in our early stages. We didn't know, we didn't have people to teach us. It was a very different reality. And so we were very eager to practice, but we were often practicing with an incorrect understanding. So it's very important to listen and benefit from those beneficial lectures that you listen to. And all throughout the internet, there are many books that are explained, and my advice is that you also learn from Islamic text, meaning you listen to lectures and you follow along the text. It's great to listen to people giving advice and people doing lectures about particular topics. This is fantastic, but you need more. You need, as far as learning, those things help to strengthen your iman and you learn. But however, you want to also take it to another level by actually going through matun or going through Islamic texts, classical works, to really get a classical understanding of what it means to understand Islam. And this is based on the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the understanding of the Salaf al-Saleh. And the Salaf al-Saleh, what we mean by that is we mean the pious predecessors. And specifically what we mean by that is we mean the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in, who were the companions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who were there when the revelation was revealed. And we also mean by that the students of the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in, and these students are known as the tabi'een, and also their students, which are called the itba'a tabi'een. They are called the followers of the followers of the companions, radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. And so this is very important because you want to gain a good solid understanding of your creed, of the Islamic creed and belief system, and you want to gain a good understanding of the Islamic madhab or minhaj, methodology for understanding and approaching the Quran and approaching the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So you want to be cautious of those who you listen to. Another important point I want to mention is that also along with that, those studies is that you continue to gain a halal livelihood. Do not be like those people who make everything haram and are so afraid that they don't work. Alhamdulillah, Allah has favored you with a job. Keep your job and benefit around those hours that you have off. Another important point that I want to emphasize that you're already doing, because I saw you're with my Habib, one of my beloved companions, is I want you to stick very close to him and stick close to those other people who are calling to the Sunnah and who advise you with good. And you'll be able to see when someone is advising you to something good and something that comforts the heart, not that something that corrupts the heart, as you mentioned with those individuals who said, no, don't pray in the masajid, pray in my apartment. No, don't go to Jumu'ah, pray in my apartment. Things that are very strange, things that are very gharib, things that kind of call you away from the jama'ah. Because there's too many people from Ahl Sunnah here in the Seattle area that you can go and benefit from and sit in the gatherings of khair and khair and sunnah. So please do yourself a favor by striving and learning to come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and having good companies. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned, al-mar'i al-adina khalilihi, that a person is upon the religion of his companion. So meaning that if you take good people for your companions, meaning good people who are adhering to the book and the sunnah and have good manners and have other beautiful attributes, then more than likely you're going to be affected by those beautiful and righteous attributes and and beautiful advice according to the sunnah, the book and the sunnah. And if you are sitting with people who may have good manners, but yet their advice is kind of corrupt, that they are calling you to their group or their clique or their sect, or they're calling you to be away from the Muslims and hate the Muslims and make takfir of the Muslims, then you know that that's a corrupt gathering, and that's a gathering that will corrupt your heart, and it's a gathering that will take you away truly from the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So you want to be in good company. You want to be around those people who can help you grow in your Islam, because we grow in our faith. We grow, and we're continually growing until we get into the grave. That doesn't mean we grow out of the correct aqidah or we grow out of the correct methodology, la, but it means that we're growing and becoming stronger based on actually analyzing and based on likewise restricting ourselves within the hadood or the boundaries that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala set from the book and the sunnah. And so those are just some advice, pieces of advice that I can offer, and I ask that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blesses us all with ilm al-nafi wa rizqan tayyib wa amalan mutaqabbilan, and raises our status with him tabaraka wa ta'ala, forgives us of our sins, and allows for us to have righteous companions and to go forward until we meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala